Students, now we are discussing the question answers of this chapter 2 in geography, physical features of India. Here I will discuss about differentiate, means how the Himalayan range formation and how the peninsula plateau were formed. So first of all, we are discussing about the formation things. In first point, in Himalaya region, Youngfold mountains made from the uplifts of the strata formed by the sedimentary rocks. Means Himalaya region, Himalayan mountains are made by the upliftments of the strata. Those are made by the sedimentary rocks. Now the peninsula plateau, these are the oldest Gondwana lands part, and this is the ancient landmass created after splitting of Gondwana land. Means these are the oldest landmass, and peninsular plateau is the made by the Gondwana land. Now the second point, in Himalaya region, it is consist of the loftiest mountain and deep valleys. Means it has the loftiest mountains and deep valleys. And in this peninsular plateau, it consists of broad and shallow valleys. Means it doesn't have mountains. It doesn't have shallow valleys and rounded hills. In the third point of Himalaya region, composed by sedimentary rocks, means this Himalayan region made by the rocks of sedimentary. And the peninsula plateau, this composed by the igneous and metamorphic rocks. So these are the major difference between them. Next, fourth point says that it is the origin of perennial rivers. Means from the Himalaya mountain regions, so many perennial rivers are coming down. And in peninsula plateau, it has rain-fed or seasonal rivers. Means it doesn't have perennial river. It has only rain-fed and seasonal rivers. Now in the fifth point of Himalaya region, from the point of view of geology, this region forms an unstable zone. Means Himalaya region is not stable. In the point of view of geology, it is an unstable zone. And peninsula plateau is the stable zone. Means this is the stable zone. So I hope you understand all the 5 points. It is the differentiate between the peninsular and Himalaya region. Now we are moving in the short notes. Means these are the very important question. And in this question, we are writing the 3 different short notes. First, on Indian desert. We had already discussed in our previous videos where is the location of Indian desert and what is the things between them. So the Indian desert, means the location of Indian desert towards the western margin of Aravalli Hills. Means this is the locate on the western side of Aravalli Hills. It is an undulating sandy plains. Means this is the sandy plains covered with sand dunes called bajans. Means we are calling the sand dunes also bajans. These regions receive very, very low rainfall, below it approximately below 150 millimeter per year. This is the annual rainfall. It has arid climate with low vegetation, covered streams upper during the rainy season. Soon after, they disappear into the sand as they do not have enough water. Means it has only one river. Some small streams are there, and it is appear only in the rainy season. It is disappear into the sand as they do not have enough water to reach the sea. Luni is the only larger river in this region. Means in this region, Luni is the largest river of this Indian desert. So I hope you understand properly these differentiate and short note. We will continue in the next videos to next other short notes. So stay safe and note it down. Thank you. Good afternoon, students. Now we had discussed about the question short note on the following topics. We had already completed the western desert of India. So in this chapter, physical features of India, and now we are discussing about the 2 topics. There is the question is short note on the central highlands and the island groups of India. So this is the very vast things consisting of the central highlands. So now you can write it and learn it today. सेंट्रल हाईलैंड, द सेंट्रल हाईलैंड इट मींस द पार्ट ऑफ द पेरेंसुला प्लेटू लाइंग टू द नॉर्थ ऑफ नर्मदा कवरिंग अ मेजर एरिया ऑफ मालवा प्लेटू. मीन्स दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द पेरेंसुला प्लेटू लाइंग टू द नॉर्थ ऑफ द नर्मदा एंड द एरिया ऑफ मालवा प्लेटू. दिस इज कॉल्ड द सेंट्रल हाईलैंड्स. सो द विंध्या रेंज इज बाउंडेड बाय द सेंट्रल हाईलैंड्स. मीन्स दिस सेंट्रल हाईलैंड्स बाउंडेड बाय द विंध्या रेंजेस ऑन द साउथ ऑफ द अरावली रेंज ऑन द नॉर्थ वेस्ट. मीन्स दिस इज कवर्ड बाय नॉर्थ एंड साउथ ऑफ द अरावली ऑन द नॉर्थ वेस्ट. सो दिस इज द लोकेशन ऑफ दिस सेंट्रल हाईलैंड्स. नाउ we are discussing about the rivers. The flow of rivers draining these regions means different big rivers are flowing in this region. Name are the Chambal, Sindh, the Betwa and Ken. Is from southwest to northwest. Means these rivers Chambal, Sindh, Betwa and Ken are flowing to the southwest to northwest. Thus indicating the slope. So for this the slope are there southwest to northwest. The central highlands are wider in the west but narrower in the east. Means these islands are wider in the west and narrower in the east. The eastward extension of this plateau are locally known as Bundelkhand and Bagelkhand. Means locally their name and this extension are Bundelkhand and Bagelkhand. The Chota Nagpur Plateau marks the further eastward extension. Means where is the location of Chota Nagpur Plateau? Their location is eastward extension and drained by the Damodar River. Means this Damodar River is lying on the Chota Nagpur Plateau. So I hope you understand the location and the advantages and rivers name of the central highlands, so you can note it down. Our next topic is the island group of India. So India has two island groups, Andaman and Nicobar Island and Lakshadweep Island. Here we discuss the Lakshadweep. Later on we discuss the Andaman and Nicobar. So India has two main island groups. Names are Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar. The Lakshadweep consists of many small islands. Means Lakshadweep consists of small islands. It is a group of islands and opposite to Kerala coast. This is the location of this island is opposite to the Kerala coast in the which sea Arabian Sea. It covers small area. It has a very small area of 32 km square. Kavaratti Island is the administrative headquarters of Lakshadweep. Means Kavaratti is also a headquarter of the administrative headquarter of Lakshadweep and it is the capital of this island. So I hope you understand properly these group of islands. Later on we discuss the Andaman and Nicobar, so you can learn it, write it and understand properly. So I think you stay safe. Thank you.